Danny D, take one. Danny D, take 30. I've always wanted to do that.
Oh, you ready for me? So many great Danny Davis stories, probably way too many to count. But probably one of the best things about Danny is actually hearing him tell stories, because he's one of the best, especially when he gets in one of those, telling about one from his childhood up in Arkansas, and he gets in his voice right here and starts talking about it. It's real awesome. When I first started working for Danny, I remember texting him about, hey, I've got an idea for this song. And I didn't look back down at the text, and I didn't hear from him for a bit. And then about an hour or two later, I realized what I wrote. I didn't write the word song. You can replace that first letter of the word, or first letter of the of song with the fourth letter of the alphabet. And I thought that he was really, really mad at me. And so I was freaking out because he didn't respond. And then about 4 hours later, he responds, and it's just like, ha, 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 he's going crazy. And so I was like, man, I thought I just lost a job that I just got.
You know, when Danny first came to work for us, he was actually a studio musician. It was actually just part-time for Lake Pointe. And so we had to give him a title, and the title that we gave him was Artist in Residence. And I remember after one of the worship services, one of the families in our church came up to him and inquired about the fact that he was Artist in Residence. And he said, yes, that's right, that's my role. And they asked him, well, would you give us a bid on what you would charge us to paint a picture?
I think the best part about Danny Davis is, and he would agree with me on this, is Suzanne. So I grew up at Lake Pointe watching Danny and Suzanne, but I met them through a series of events, some pretty crazy life events. I went and tried out for this TV show called American Idol and barely made it through the first rounds, and the judges there said, hey, we're going to let you through, but you need to go practice. So first thing I did was, I need some lessons. I need something. So I called up the only, you know, real music people I knew, Danny and Suzanne, said, hey, I need some help. I'd like to take some lessons on singing. And I think the coolest story with Danny that a lot of people might not know is that he was one of my biggest mentors when I was on the show. And I remember one week specifically, Mariah Carey week, I had this song I wanted to sing that I wanted to make a new arrangement for. And Danny helped me do that virtually. He was in Rockwall. I was in L.A., and he put together a really cool musical arrangement with different chords for the song, and I sang it on TV, and I don't think anybody ever knew that, but that was a Danny Davis arrangement.
Danny, I wrote this just for this occasion, okay? Just kidding.
Okay, Jake and Emmy, part one, take one. Action.
I have a lot of things I could say, but I don't know. I think I need to, like, warm up first.
Yeah, me too. Okay, we're ready.
I think one of my most memorable times with Danny was the time we were about to do the offertory main song, and the soloist was supposed to be moving up front to sing the offertory song. Sometimes that happened after the sermon, but this time it was going to happen before. And the soloist thought it was going to happen afterwards, so he left the stage. So we had to go into the song. We hear the click starting, and the monitor engineer says, Danny, the soloist is gone. And I saw him from behind, and I could see him just kind of stiffen up like this. And he just started walking towards the microphone. He hadn't rehearsed it. We didn't know if it was in his key or not, and we just had to fly on it. And he nailed it. He nailed it. It was amazing. He hit every note. We don't know how he remembered the melody because he hadn't learned it, but he did. And that was that was a typical Danny Davis thing. No drama, no excitement, just nailed it.
It happened back in 2005. It was my first trek camp ever, and Danny and Suzanne were there as leaders because their kids were there, Jake and Emmy. And I remember at one point, me and some of the band guys were down by the tug-of-war pit, kind of yelling and carrying on, having a good time with kids. And I remember Danny kind of pulled me aside, and it was the first time we'd ever really met, and he's like, "Hey, man, you might want to take it easy on your voice a little bit. You still got three more days of this." And I was like, "No, man, I'm good. Well, fast forward, we get to the last night of camp, and it's the worship service is outside, up under a cross. It's pitch black, and there's about 400 students out there, and it's an acoustic. And I remember singing the song, Blessed Be Your Name. You give and take away, and I remember right when I said the words take away, my voice disappeared. And I kept trying to come back in and sing, and I couldn't. And about that time, I see this figure walking down, and it was Danny. And he stood right there beside me while I played guitar, and he sang the words for me.
Where do I begin? There are lots of funny stories that I have about Danny, Suzanne. I've known him for a long time. I would say that, I used to spend time with them at their apartment when they were newlyweds. And later on, it was funny when kind of realized that maybe they would rather have been alone than rather just with me there. I do remember when they moved to Tennessee, that went up there and spent some time, and we installed a hardwood floor, and both of us were really, really hurting after installing that hardwood floor. And then, of course, they moved and came back here, and I don't remember getting any of the proceeds from the sale of that house with those hardwood floors. I'm still waiting on that check, by the way.
Danny Davis, 30 years. Wow. I can't even begin to, you know what that means? It means you're really old. Actually, cut that. Don't say that. It's probably going to make it in there. Thanks, Craig. I can't even begin to imagine just the thousands of people that you have impacted through your talent, your ability, and more specifically, more personally, your heart for the Lord and leading other people to Him through worship is it's so real and evident every time you sing and every time you lead us. We're just grateful for the impact that you've had on literally thousands of people here. So, man, congrats on 30 years. Man, that's such an incredible accomplishment. I'm grateful for not only the ministry that you've had here, but the friendship that we've shared all these years. Love you, buddy.
There's this one time when our dad was on stage and he had his guitar on, and probably everybody knows this story because it was so funny. And so my dad had his water bottle, and he was like, "Oh, I forgot to take my guitar off." So he went to take his guitar off, and his arm got stuck up here, and the entire water bottle dumped down his back, like on his head, down his back, in front of the whole auditorium, and everybody towards the front section was like, like.
My mom just does stuff kind of absentmindedly sometimes. She's like super friendly, kind of like always touching on people, like, you know, grabbing their hand when she's talking or whatever, you know, touching their arm. I guess she was like standing in the hallway behind the behind the stage, and waiting to go out there. And Pastor Steve walks by her. She was holding a water bottle, and it was just one of those impulse things. I guess she just like smacked Pastor Steve on the butt with her with her water bottle, and Pastor Steve was just kind of like, whoop, and she "Did I just hold on? Did I just?" Oops.
Wait a minute.
Pastor Steve's probably pretty good humor about it, but he might not even remember it. Now he does, so.
Now he does.
That's a true story.
Yay. But good thing we brought that back up.
That was a pretty good one.
Danny will be always famous for his purple leisure suit. During that time period where that was in style and Danny was wearing it, we called him Barney.
The world turns much faster on this Christmas. Oh, hey, it snuck up on me. Hey, so Danny, I wanted to say happy 30 years at Lake Pointe, and wanted to say thank you for what you've done in my life. I remember about 20 years ago, I was helping out on a weekend and just volunteering, and you told me, to come back whenever I wanted, and you were just really inviting and gave me an opportunity, and I've always appreciated that. I'll never forget
what you've done for me. So I love you. Love Suzanne. Hope you're all doing great. And congratulations, Danny.
Well, hello, Danny, Suzanne, and friends. 30 years, that's incredible. I remember when Stroop approached me about bringing you guys on as artist in residence way back then. And I said, well, that's a no-brainer. And then to be able to bring you on staff and transition through all those different worship styles. You remember the time when he wanted us to do everything thematic. And so what did we do? We did our own thematic courses, you, me, and Tina English. Great times. You guys are incredible. You've built a fantastic program, and I'm just delighted that I got to be a part of those early days with you guys. And you mean a lot to me, and you never whined, you never griped. Anything I ask you to do, you were always there, and I just want you to know I appreciate it. You're a big part of my life. Love you a bunch. Greetings from Angel Fire.
Hey, Danny, Chris Clayton. Hey, congratulations on 30 years of service there at Lake Pointe. That's a huge milestone. Thanks for investing in the people of Lake Pointe, but also thanks for investing in people like me, worship leaders, band members, vocalists, production crew. Thanks for taking a chance on me to come and lead worship there at Lake Pointe and still allow me to come back and lead there. So that shows a huge testament that it's not about you, it's about building the kingdom. And that's a huge thing that I take away every time I'm with you. So thank you for your investment in all of these areas and for building the kingdom of God there at Lake Pointe. I look forward to what God has for you as you continue to serve there at Lake Pointe. God bless you, brother. We'll talk to you soon.
Hey, Danny, man. So neat to be able to make a little video like this to celebrate 30 years, man, all that you guys have brought to Lake Pointe and how God has just continually used you over the years, man, faithfully. I have been so blessed by just even my small visits to be part of that community there, man. It really is a family, and that is largely to do with how you guys carry yourselves in that setting. So, man, congratulations. God bless you guys, and man, I hope we get to see you again soon.
Mom and Daddy, thank you for just being the most amazing people ever and for being so much fun and just for making life just awesome. And I don't even know really what to say because, like, everything about you I love. And I just want to hang out with y'all every day. And thank you for making my life just 100% happy and just for showing us, just giving us the best examples to live up to. And I hope that I can be somewhat of a parent as good as y'all. But, like, in the future, this isn't some, like, weird pregnancy announcement. I'm just saying. And but thank you so much. And I love y'all.
Thank you, Danny.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, y'all.
Danny Davis, from the bottom of my heart, thank you.
Good morning. It's good to have you at Lake Pointe this morning.
Good morning. Welcome to Lake Pointe Church.
Good evening. Merry Christmas.
Of your love. the brightest days and through the darkest nights. All my hope is knowing you are by my side. Mercy, endless mercy, come what may. Every moment proves the power.
A couple decades ago, we gave personality tests to all of our staff members, and when Danny's came back, it said that his number one strength was adaptability. And then all of a sudden, it made a lot of sense to me that whenever we needed Danny to change something or to do something a little different, that his answer was always yes, because he was willing to do whatever it took to further the cause of Christ, to share Christ and build believers. And that's been one of the reasons it's been such a pleasure to work with Danny, is Danny is a team member. He's never been a prima donna. He's never had to have his way or no way. And it's made all the difference in the world in us being able to do what we've done here at Lake Pointe over the last 40 years.
Every day let the song of my life sing. Every day let the cry of my heart be thank you. Every day let the song of my life sing. Every day let the cry of my heart be thank you. Every day let the song of my life sing. Every day let the cry of my heart be thank you. Every day let the song of my life sing. Every day let the cry of my heart be thank you. Let every breath, every thought, every heartbeat, every day let the song of my life sing thank you. Thank you for the cross, for the grave, for your glory. Every day let the cry of my heart be thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
It's happening. It's happening in my church. It's happening in yours too. And so just be encouraged that what we do does make a difference. And so let's keep doing it and let's keep improving on it. All right? See y'all later.
All right. Thanks for being here today. We'll see you next weekend.